more than jets. I like more than sex, but nothing in this world that I like more than checks.
Money.
All I really wanna see is the
money.
I don't really need a D, I need the
money.
All a bad bitch need is the
money.
I got bands in the coupe, bustin' out the roof. I got bands in the coupe. Touch me, I'll shoot. Bow. Shake a little ass.
Money.
You get a little bag and take it to the store.
Money.
Get a little cash.
Money.
You shake it real fast. You get a little more.
Money.
I got bands in the coupe.
I have a chastity jacket. Don't mind me.
Oh, I have pants.
Oh. It's 2019. Ladies are out here wearing pants under their dresses.
It's a recent development.
Hi, you guys. Thanks for coming out today. Yay! So, let's do this. Hi, I'm Courtney.
I'm Dara.
And this is Next Big Thing with Courtney and Dara.
Oh!
Hello!
Yes.
Yay! How many people in this space have heard or seen this show before?
Woo!
Okay.
Love it.
Okay. For the uninitiated, Courtney and I highlight. Go ahead.
Yeah, we're two dope techies.
I know you want to say it.
We are two dope techies, Courtney and Dara,
mm-hmm.
and we like to highlight millennials of color that are doing dope work in tech, media, and entrepreneurship.
That's right. We usually start out the show talking about current events.
Yes.
There's always something current, and it's eventful, and then we talk about it.
That we need to talk about.
Mm-hmm.
So we have some things to talk about today.
Mm-hmm. And then we bring up our interview guest and then talk to them. You're going to be really excited to meet this lady. And then at the end, we'll play a little game, and it's going to be fun, and everybody's going to have a great time.
Yeah.
Yeah? You guys are quiet.
Yeah, get those.
What's up? Come on.
I don't know if anyone joined us last year, but the same rules apply.
Mm.
Feel free to send drinks up to this stage at any given time.
I'm drinking Manhattans.
I'm drinking a mix between vodka, champagne. I don't know. Surprise me.
You know what? This ice water is just ice.
Don't even try it.
I was, okay, I see. No, that's a mistake.
Oh, that's a pitcher.
Yeah. No, I'm going to spill that real fast. So I'll just leave that there. Let the heat do my work.
All right.
You want to jump in?
Yeah.
Let's start with?
We're going to start with some current events.
Mm-hmm.
It's a brand new year.
Mm-hmm.
Hashtag new year, same me.
Because you're already fabulous.
But we made some 2019 resolutions. I don't know how many of you all do these types of things, a dry or sober January maybe in the house somewhere. Holler, congratulations, you guys, you're almost there. Almost. But me, myself, I made a 2019 resolution to spend less money on takeout. Because in San Francisco, DoorDash, Uber Eats, Postmates, we got into a serious relationship over the holidays. It's bae.
You and cheesy fries is bae.
Oh, I've had nothing but cheese fries for the last week. It's been great.
It's been just tuck that in a little bit.
Tuck that in just a little bit tighter. What were your 2019 resolutions?
Stay wonderful and amazing and everything else.
I love
Don't clap for that. That's a lie. I've got a lot of work to do. This old Dara is the name of the show.
We're fixing her up.
I'm trying to perform more.
Oh, great.
Just a little
perform
bit
more types of...
All kinds of things. Comedy things.
Comedy things.
Yeah, things like this where everyone's wildly entertained. Mm-hmm. Producing more of our own stuff.
Yes.
Yeah, we talked about before, like, we're both, like, kind of hesitant about the comedy, bro-y, racist, sexist scene. So we're trying to create our own spaces where nobody's allowed to do that.
Amen. That's what we are doing here on stage today with Next Big Thing.
That's right. Yeah. So the next time you see me doing something, come there, too. Just follow me around.
Yeah. Literally follow us around.
Follow me
the
around.
The streets. Well... We're millennials, so one of the things that people are talking about, it's apparently such a dirty, bad, bad word, but I like it. And one of an article that came out recently from BuzzFeed, no, it was from an independent writer.
I don't remember, because millennials don't know specifics.
We don't know anything. That's kind of true. Like, I'll be like, oh, yeah, I read this article, and then I'll be like, okay, I read the title of a headline for the article. I'm pretty sure that's all the nuance I need to report on this right now. But apparently millennials are burned out.
Yeah. It was BuzzFeed.
There was another BuzzFeed article.
Trust yourself, black woman.
No, I do trust myself. I do. Because there was a follow-up article from BuzzFeed written by a black woman that said, mm-hmm. okay, well, this is what, like, y'all have millennial burnout, but let me talk to y'all about black millennial burnout. Because we deal with racism and microaggressions, and, you know, maybe someone doesn't want to pick us up in a cab one day. Maybe someone feels like calling us niggers the next day, and we're supposed to just go to work and have a smile on our face and, like, do this meeting and, you know, give a report. Like, nothing happened. So that is a special type of burnout
yeah.
that we experience.
Yes, we're both very tired.
We're very tired.
Welcome to our TED Talk. We are exhausted.
We're Courtney and Dara, and we're tired.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Millennials under fire.
Literally fire festival is what we're referring to.
Yeah,
that's where we...
I wish to God I had done that on purpose.
Oh, my God.
I would have dropped the mic and walked away.
That was so
short
perfect.
Short show, sorry. I killed so it, so that's it.
Yeah, what is bringing up this conversation again around millennials are these documentaries from the now infamous Fire Festival. Mm-hmm. Did anyone here buy a ticket to Fire Festival when it was... Show yourselves. I'm so curious.
Let us hear your woos. Nobody? You're lying. There's no way. We're in San Francisco. There's no way one of you didn't go.
Well, I was saying I never heard of the Fire Festival until I was at my office. I worked in HR at a tech company the year that, my old coworkers are like right here. at a tech company, and we had not one but two employees that were trying to get to Fire Festival, but we were getting text message updates that, yeah, there's no food, there's no water, they have us in tents, we're not sure if we're going to get off the island. And we were like, how did this happen? What is this Fire Festival?
And then came the documentaries.
And then came the documentaries and Ja Rule.
So beautiful.
I love
it. So terrible.
So has anyone watched the documentaries is the next question. Yes. Oh, yes, we're watching it. Great.
Okay. Courtney got Hulu to watch the documentary.
I did. Because I had Netflix, and my girl was texting me, like, have you seen this? And I was also an event planner at one point, so I watched the Netflix documentary in horror, sheer horror at how many questions were not asked to this fast-talking white man about we're going to take all these rich white kids to the Bahamas. Come on, red flags, guys.
Save a little bit of horror for the fact that a guy was like, they told me I had to take one for the team.
The Evian. Oh, God. Spoiler?
Go down. Oh, it's a spoiler? No, it's the internet. It's too fast.
Okay.
That was last week. It's old news.
Well, someone was willing to take one for the team.
Meaning?
And in order to get the Evian, the large shipment of Evian bottles that they had shipped to the Bahamas, there was going to be a custom fee of about $130,000. And they said, you know what? Gay man? They said, like, you're gay.
Which, like, don't start sentences that way.
So many red flags.
End well.
So many red flags. But here's the thing. The guy was ready to take
okay,
one for
but we
the
didn't
team.
Finish. He said, gay man, gotta take one for the team.
Oh.
Go down and give the
you need
person
to go
a blowjob.
Give oral sex to the man that's holding our water
that's
hostage.
That's a nicer way to say what I just said.
Yeah.
I should have said that. I should have said oral sex.
And the man got himself showered. Got himself dressed.
He said he
went down to customs.
He gargled some Listerine.
Honey,
which isn't that
like?
I think the order of operations there is wrong, and we don't need to go into the details. But I'm pretty sure that's.
But can we talk about the dedication to the job? Like, of all the horrible things that happened with the Fire Festival, someone really showed up and showed out for their job that
Listen,
day.
All I want to say is, can somebody please, I believe this man's name is Andy, can somebody point him to Flint, Michigan? Like, we got people who need water.
Get that water, boo. Do what you need to do to get this water for the kids.
Take one for the team, Andy.
It's for the kids.
It's for the kids.
It's for the kids, Andy. Take one for the kids.
R.I.P., R.I.P.
If somebody knows him, I'm hiring. So, I'm not for that. Oh, my God.
Whoa.
Oh, my God. We have to move on.
Wait. This is the perfect time to check in with the person who's running our social media, because I want to make sure that gets tweeted. Maya Janelle, over in the corner. Hello. Say
hey
hello
guys.
To the people.
Hey, people. It's a good looking group.
Aren't they cute?
It's a good looking group.
Yes.
It's true.
Hit us on the buzz at the socials at NBT the show. That's the hashtag I'm using to get your thoughts, prayers, praise reports, whatever you want to send in. Just send them to me.
Words of encouragement.
And yeah, you know, this is an interactive show, so appreciate you guys. Follow us. NBT the show on all the socials.
That's right.
Amen. Did you watch the Fyre Festival documentaries?
I did.
Do you have a preference for which one you preferred?
I definitely, Andy really did show up and show out with that dedication, and that's definitely like the meme, I think, out of the two festivals. But early on in the Hulu version, I knew that happened. Like, an event planner for a wedding knew you couldn't plan a wedding in 2 months, let alone a Fyre Festival.
Right.
So, that was doomed from the start.
I know.
I love that Hulu one.
I love the Hulu one, too. But it's all a mess, you guys. It's just a mess.
It's a mess. What else? What else? What else?
The world record egg happened. I was late to this trend, you guys. Did anyone like that picture of the world record egg? Yeah. Woo! Millennials. But in case you have been not on Instagram in the last 2 or 3 weeks, Kylie Jenner is right now the queen of Instagram. She was. She previously held the record for most likes on an Instagram post. So top of priority for 2019 on Instagram was somebody said, let's dethrone her. Mm-hmm. Let's put up a picture of an egg. And I would like to note it was a picture of a brown egg, not a white egg. Because in 2019, it's brown eggs out here breaking records, making strides. Yes, representation.
Representation.
Thank you.
Is so important.
Well, the egg broke the record for most likes on Instagram.
Egg.
So,
great.
Great job, you guys.
Great.
Did it.
Social media is super important.
It is really
because
important.
Because of eggs.
And just millennials being able to tell everyone what's important and what the priority is for the top of 2019.
This is, I mean, social media is like can be important. We're trying to get R. Kelly up out the paint with a hashtag, and
yes,
it's working.
Social media will reopen entire legal cases.
Right.
If your campaign is strong enough and has Rihanna and Kim Kardashian.
True enough.
Yes.
There's always a lot of, I hate to defend social media because they defend Nazis, and I'm
the
not down with Nazis,
owners.
It was just me. but people are always like, oh, it's too good for social media. Social media is the worst. But
that's
I feel
true.
Like if you get to like see yourself in magazines and billboards and TV shows and movies all the time, then you don't need a place where other voices are heard.
Mm-hmm.
But if you are a tiny little black spot in the middle of a sea of white, sometimes it's nice to find your friends on the internet and be like, ain't that some shit? And they'd be like, yeah, girl, that's some shit. Or like to learn about people who are not like you.
Exactly.
I don't know.
Meet up with people that maybe do think like you but are so separated for systemic reasons, generational reasons. Mm. I got into social media because I was like, well, no one really wants to hire me for their commercial or their television show, so I'll just create my own and I'll make a platform and I'll put myself out there because I think I'm pretty cute and funny, so let's do this.
And here we are.
Here we
and
are.
And here she is, folks.
And here I am.
We did it.
And that's how simple it is. And when you encourage others through social media, through other, you know, medias that we don't even know may exist, you know, keep that in mind.
That's
it's
right.
Really good. It gets people to places like here on even larger platforms with darker skin and more. Just more.
Just more.
Let's just do more of that in 2019. Will you guys make that resolution with us?
Yeah.
More. Wow.
So attractive.
You ready for our guest?
I want to talk about one more thing.
Oh, what will we got to talk about, girl? Let's talk about it.
Because you went to a school.
Oh, my gosh. She's talking about Howard University, you guys. Oh, there's some Howard grads in the building. Yes,
okay.
So you will love this.
They are an enthusiastic bunch.
That's true. There's one more thing we have to talk about.
Yeah, go ahead.
We're getting ready to elect a new potential president for 2020.
God,
that's exciting. You can applaud something about that, whether you like this current president, whether you're ready for him to step down, whatever it is.
If you like this current president, you are going to be disappointed in this show. So.
Yay! I'm so glad you're here. But exciting news was announced on Monday that Kamala Harris is running for president.
Mm-hmm.
She's our current Attorney General for the state of California.
No.
Thank you.
Senator.
Jesus.
She was.
I'm sorry. Was. God.
She was.
There's some senators here. My goodness. Sorry. Your honors. I'm so sorry, Mr. President. Goodness. She is a senator. I did vote for her. I know that. It was on the ballot. I got it.
Yeah.
But it's notable because she is another African-American slash Indian woman.
Yeah.
So we're making strides. She's another black woman that went to Howard University. So I don't know, but you're looking at one black woman that went to Howard University. There's several people. My mother is here. She also went to Howard University. Right, but with that said, these aren't reasons to vote for someone into the highest office in the land, right?
Yep.
In theory.
How are your feelings?
My feelings are I'm a registered independent, so Democrats, y'all don't get my vote automatically. I need to do my research. I think independently, and I vote otherwise. But just to let you know, and this is fair warning, if I decide that I am Team Kamala for 2020, y'all will never hear the end of it, especially if she wins. And the first black female president is from Howard University. You will never not hear a woman from Howard University tell you that fact. Fun joke.
Yeah, you should, go ahead.
How can you tell if a woman's from Howard University?
How?
You don't. She'll tell you.
Yeah. Literally cracking yourself up right now. I love
it. It's because it's so true.
I'm not sure.
Yeah, how you feeling, girl?
I'm not sure how I feel.
Tell us about it. You know?
No, he's talking about Harvard University. I know that voice.
I'm pretty sure Harvard stole that from Howard.
Let's not do this now. I don't know how I feel about her because she was an attorney general.
Yes, there we go.
And I am the child of defense attorneys. Mm. And so I think I might be contractually obligated never to side with the prosecution.
Some defense attorneys in the house. Here we go.
Some defense attorneys.
And their children in the house.
Yeah. Shout out to my father who is standing right there talking through while I'm doing this.
No, like, he's legit, man.
So, because I'm up on the stage and I'm doing something and you're like, you're talking.
He birthed you, so give him a pass.
He sure didn't.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I tried, Mr. Wilson. I tried. I'm so sorry.
Nope.
I tried.
Nope, that didn't happen.
Oh, Mr. Wilson.
Good. Let's flash all the way back to middle school. Bring out all the hits. All right, that's all I wanted to say.
You're not sure yet.
She the cops.
You're not sure. She's the cops. Yeah. Well, it sounds like you are sure. She 5-0?
Yeah.
Okay, well, with that said.
But I'm still, you know, maybe.
Let's all do our research, you know? Yeah. Like, we've got nowhere to go but up. So, the learning curve is a little not steep. So do your due diligence, and we'll see who we end up with in 2020.
But don't give her more criticism than everybody else, which has already been started.
Check your biases. Check them. She's a brown woman.
People are combing through her background and just not even talking about other folks. So
right. And if you want to look at an example of due process, the duest process I've ever seen in my 30 years.
Do you remember when we were in our 20s and we started the show?
I know, time has passed.
Oh my God.
We got grown on this show. We could tell y'all some stories. Due process is happening with our current administration. They're going through with a fine-tooth comb. They're asking lots of questions and making arrests later. So let's give our candidates, especially the female ones of color, that same consideration.
That's right.
Over and over and over and over again.
All right.
Fabulous.
We got it out of our systems.
Yes. We've talked current events.
We've talked current events.
We've talked the events of the day.
We should have, outro music for that.
my friend.
Nobody watches the news? You don't know what I'm talking about?
No. We don't watch the news. No one watches the news. We go on Twitter and we see what's trending.
Okay.
That's what we do. We're ready for our guest?
Yeah.
Let's do it. Are you guys ready to meet our next guest?
Woo! Okay. I'm going to read this because I want to get it right.
She deserves it.
Yes, she is. A stand-up comedian, writer, and actress, best known as the woman in a wheelchair with no feet who won a treadmill on The Price is Right.
No, that's laugh. True. She encourages it.
That's
laugh.
True. She's been featured on BuzzFeed, CNN, Hoo Ha Ha, Jimmy Kimmel Live, Entertainment Tonight. Coconut is her favorite flavor of LaCroix because she's not afraid to be the villain.
Yes.
It's Danielle Perez.
Yes. Welcome her up on stage. Yes. Let's keep it going. Welcome to the stage, Danielle.
Hey, thank you for having me.
Oh my God, absolutely. So you're just so pretty.
Oh, thank you. You're pretty. You guys are so, clap it for this beauty. This black beauty on stage. We got beat in the afternoon for this.
Yes. Okay. I was gonna follow it up with, so you agree. You think you're really pretty. But she's out here complimenting us, so I can't say my joke. Stop. Nerve. So, how you doing, girl?
I'm doing. I'm living. I'm wearing the same dress I wore last night. You know, I'm really out here. Honey. Out here in San Francisco.
Last night was cracking.
In the culture.
We did all meet up last night at the SF Sketchfest after party at Speakeasy. Mm-hmm. Got a little lit.
Held up that photo booth for a hot minute.
Oh, yeah.
One more. We looked so good.
We looked really good. Don't worry. We'll post them. We'll post them. But yeah, first we want to just jump right in. What happened on The Price is Right? How did you get there? And tell us that story.
The Price is Right. So I live in Los Angeles, and one of my good friends, she's a stand-up comedian. She was moving to New York, and she wanted to do all these like LA bucket list things. So it's like, let's go to a taping, and The Price is Right. I go, and I'm just there to hang out, just there to participate with them. And I was the first name called down to Contestants Row.
Yes.
I was there at Contestants Row the entire show.
Wow.
It was the last game to get on stage. We had to play it two times because everyone overbid. I don't know if anyone here is a Big Price is Right fan.
Y'all be doing it?
That's how it works. All right, you overbid, you got to play the game again. Everyone overbid.
Yep.
Second round, I made it on stage.
Yes.
Okay, I made it on stage, and the prizes were a treadmill and a walk-in sauna. And the audience was like, oh.
Kind of like how you all were just
there. Right now. But I won that shit. And the internet fucking freaked out.
Legit, I saw it, and it was like a story, and then I looked, and I was like, I know that girl.
Oh, my God.
I was interviewed by BBC, CNN, People Magazine, girl.
You
like,
all over the place.
I was. I realized. I was like, oh, my God, I'm going to get so much dick now because I'm internet famous.
Yes! Did you?
Yes, a lot of
it's
old
continuing.
Men from Penis Past was really trying to knock on that door, and it was like, oh, I'm sorry, VIP only.
Oh,
okay.
Ghost very
the ghost of Penis Past. This is fabulous. And then
Jimmy Kimmel Live, like the producers of Jimmy Kimmel saw it and were like, this is wild. So they hit me up. They announced it on their show like the night the episode aired. And the next day, I was a guest on Jimmy Kimmel Live.
Oh, my God.
It was insane.
Get it how you get it.
So how is Jimmy? Because I saw him once at like a live
First
Haley
basis.
Center. Oh, Jimmy.
Jimmy, you know, Jimmy boy.
And Jimmy was like acting up a little bit. He like went off on like an audience member, like low key.
Did they heckle him?
I think he received it as heckling. When it sounded like a misunderstanding. And me and my friend were just sitting back like, oh, he mad.
Well,
big mad.
Big
know,
mad.
Being on stage is audience participation is really clapping and laughing. Mm. And you guys know your role. You guys are doing a great job.
Yes.
You guys,
great.
Yes, you know?
Yes.
So good.
We always
that's
say
appropriate.
Church rules. Yes.
Yeah.
Well, and that's it.
But I don't like, truly, the producers were like, show up. At 4 o'clock, the show tapes at 5. They did not give me hair. They did not give me makeup.
You
they did not give me
so
wardrobe.
Good.
Honey, I showed up in a sequin bodycon dress. I had my two best friends with me. I got a blowout. I fucking did my makeup, beat to the gods. They didn't know what they were getting when I showed up. But I kept asking. I was like, are there any questions, anything you want me to go over? They're like, no. Once the doors open, just roll to Jimmy. I was like, what? So the doors just open, and I rolled to Jimmy, and we just started talking like we've known each other for years, just chopping it up, mixing it up.
Wow. So you didn't even meet him before?
No, that was literally the entire interaction I had with Jimmy Kimmel can be seen in the clip online. That's it. That's the full extent of it. And
And he gave you a cruise.
He did. He asked me to guess the price of peanut butter. And I was like, I don't know.
Yeah, I saw that. It was hella random.
I was like, I don't like peanut butter. He's like, what? I was like, I'm a Nutella girl. He's like, are you an American? I was like, wow, rude. But it didn't matter because he gave me a cruise. But then, like, when they were announcing it, they're like, wheelchair-accessible cruise, wheelchair-accessible accommodations, wheelchair-accessible sauna. Like, it was great. It was very funny.
Was the cruise fun?
I didn't go. I'm so terrible. You guys,
this is a scandal
real talk,
and a scoop.
I hate cruises.
That's super real.
They cannot
get this
so right.
They were so excited. They're like, Jimmy wants to do something super nice. But, like, that isn't why I didn't go. I just got really busy, and I kept, like, pushing it off. And I was like, I want to do, like, an auction where we auction off the treadmill, and it's a live show, and I do stand-up, and Jimmy's involved. And then I just kept getting busier and busier. I was like, I'm a stand-up comedian. They were like, that's adorable. Okay.
And your name is Danielle who?
Yeah, exactly.
I understand not being into cruises. Like,
what's your cruise experience?
None.
Well, the thing about, here's the deal with cruises. I don't know if you've ever been to one, but it's essentially a Vegas hotel on a boat in the ocean.
Yeah.
That's it. So you're fighting for space with old people all the time. There's buffets. Maybe I'm not explaining it right. It sounds, everyone's like, I don't know what the problem is, Danielle. I'm like, it's a nightmare. Because that means I'm constantly fighting for the elevator access with old people. And it's like, well, you have a walker. You're very close to death. I guess I'm not that disabled, you know? I guess maybe I'm the most able-bodied person on the ship. Sorry.
I just feel like cruises seem dangerous. And because
Girl, Titanic was like hundreds of years ago.
Oh my god!
There was just a thing toppling over in Greece like 2 years ago.
Oh, but that was a septic tank. Just don't pee. Don't
poop. They were riding in a septic tank.
No,
what
something happened with like the poop, and so all of it started.
But I can't be in control of other people's poop. I've been alive for a long time, and that's what I've learned. This is wisdom, so you should take that. Can't be in control of other people's poop.
You can't.
I just feel like.
How did we get here? And y'all are clapping.
Control the poop. That's
your
own.
Own poop. Exactly.
If you leave here knowing one thing today, control the poop.
That is your own.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Amen, amen. Well.
I think life is dangerous enough as a brown person. Mm-hmm. I don't need to go seek out danger. Like, I could. Skip rope in front of a police, you know what I mean? Like
look too happy and giddy in front of.
Ooh.
Oh, yeah, that happened.
Yeah, 12-year-olds getting arrested for being too happy.
Oh no, they were strip searched. They weren't arrested. Oh, they were strip searched by their principal or vice principal.
That's super better.
Not they looked too giddy and happy after lunch. They must have been high and on drugs.
They were on drugs.
Ooh yeah.
Who taught you joy?
We thought we. Squeezed it out of you when we kept sending you home during pre-K.
Take off your shirt. Where's that joy?
Is that the new drug? Is that what it's called? Sniffing joy, girl?
We see you on that joy. Let's see.
You're silly.
It's a controlled substance.
You guys are
silly. It's a controlled substance. We have to be controlled. So you're a comedian.
I am. I do stand-up comedy.
Hooray.
Yay!
Yay!
And tell us, we like to learn about people's journeys because oftentimes it seems like people get success and they're like, I don't know, it just like happened. It's like, go to hell. No, it didn't. How did it happen?
What happened?
So we went like, what?
The journey.
It?
The journey was basically, I was living in LA, born and raised in LA. My best friend, Madison Shepherd. Shout out to Madison Shepherd.
Shout out, Madison.
But she was trying to do theater, like RE theater in Los Angeles.
Hey.
Why?
I have an MFA.
She said RE theater.
That's how you spell it.
RE theater in Los Angeles, which why would you do that? But her roommate was a stand-up, and we started going to his shows, and I was like, I can do this. He's not funny. If this white man can be on stage telling non-jokes, I can surely do this. Like, imagine having the hubris as a 30-year-old woman in Los Angeles to begin stand-up comedy. That's just, like, how bad he was and how funny I thought I was.
Wow.
But I did, and
now
I'm here. Next big thing, hello.
Hello.
Because she's the next big
thing.
That's
a come up.
Literally what
that's
happens
a come up.
When people come on this show.
I actually have a very similar origin story.
For comedy?
For how I got into solo performance, because I also do solo performance, which is when you do a one-man show and you don't have a penis. It's called solo performance.
Oh.
Yes.
Oh.
There's a new term for it now. And I saw a woman doing a show that was
not good.
Terrible.
Okay.
And I was like, oh, if she can do that, I can do that. Like, I can at least do whatever's happening there.
Yeah.
And also it was like really dangerous and had insidious bad things about black people, but it was coming from a black person.
Oh, that's hard when that happens.
Yeah. And then, but like the whole audience was white and no offense, cause I'm so happy y'all are here. But when white people like black stuff too much, I'm like, what's up?
But like us.
What's good? Yeah. Except for us.
Give us
we're
money.
The best. Give us money.
Give us money.
Yeah. We're gonna slide into that
but
later,
like
but
keep a distance, you know, drop it and then like walk away.
Right. So some people are sending up drinks. You can also send up money.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
It's all fine.
Did I forget to mention that?
Reparations.
Send money.
What?
Yeah. Send money, send drinks.
Send
I'll take
money,
the drinks.
Send drinks. What are you drinking?
I'm drinking a vodka soda because it's still light out.
Fabulous.
trying to keep it classy.
It's
I'm
after
not familiar
five.
With these rules.
But no, like the like, you know, seeing someone be bad, like if anyone is like, I want to do stand up or performance art or anything, just literally go to an open mic, go to a place where people practice, and then you'll be like, I can do this. That will give you the strength. Like, there's no barrier for entry. You just decide one day.
Y'all are going in. Oh my God. But after I binge watched your YouTube specials and all the things that are anything that I can Google on Danielle Perez, I was like, let me find out now. It's so funny.
So funny.
And I love how you talk about your discovery of comedy and your journey in comedy as one of healing as well. Can you talk a little bit about that?
Sure. I mean, like, I started comedy when I was 30 years old. I am fat, black, Afro-Latina, disabled.
Woo! We love those things.
All these intersections, thank you. No. I am a huge narcissist and that feeds my soul. No, but like, I really didn't know what I wanted to do with my life, frankly. I lost my legs. I used to live in San Francisco. I was going to San Francisco State, was hit by a Muni streetcar, okay, Oceanside. And I'm alive, though, right? I'm here. I'm on the stage. Hello.
Right.
Got carried
so
on the stage. We're doing it.
And so pretty.
And so pretty. And oh most importantly, I'm still fucking pretty. So.
Oh, my God. So important.
Okay. I got these G's, you know, because the Lord giveth, the Lord taketh. And, all right? I'm
That's
out here.
That's how I feel about my butt, because I don't have one.
But you got that, girl. You got that. You know.
Can't have everything.
It's all
Can't
evening out in the wash. But.
Hi,
Hi, Darstad.
No, he loves it.
But, like, I really didn't know what the fuck I wanted to do. But the first time I went to an open mic and I did comedy and people engaged like by laughter. They were like, oh, I love what you're saying. I think you're funny. Like that fed my soul so much. And it was like, oh shit, this is what I want to do for the rest of my life. Like
yes.
I just want to entertain people. Yeah. I want to laugh. I want like, I you know, cause like growing up, it's like before I lost my legs, it was like, you know, Afro-Latina woman. I did not see myself in media. I didn't see myself on TV, in the movies. I just did not exist. Like now as an adult, I'm finding out, you know what I mean? Like the cast of Fresh Prince of Bel-Air is like, half of them were Afro-Latino. I didn't know that growing up. Right. I didn't see that. And so, like, being able to just, like, growing up loving theater and dance and music and, like, being, like, in high school plays and stuff like that, it's like I did it knowing it's, like, it's not going to lead anywhere. But now it's like, oh, I can actually fucking do this.
Mm-hmm.
And this can be my whole life. And it's, I don't know, I just feel like it's very exciting. And it's really amazing.
It is, it is.
I don't know,
amazing.
It feels empowering to find the thing that you give a shit about.
Yes.
Right. And what you don't know is that somebody else is looking at you saying, oh, she's doing it, maybe I can do it too.
Oh, that's really, I don't know, I always get really like self-conscious when people are like
when they're like,
because like, I'm not a role model, real talk, you know, I got a DUI, I've had an abortion, I've done some shit. I've lived a full life.
Those are all things.
But those are things that
role models can do.
They've done.
Yeah.
They do.
Yes. Shout your abortion. It's fine.
Shout your abortion. Hashtag shout
it's
your abortion.
Shout
I'm
your
sorry.
Abortion.
For baby ears, shmushmortion is what it rhymes with. I'm just kidding.
This is uncensored. Okay. Raw
I've
and
heard
real.
Shmushmortion.
No, but we're not taking any of your shame. So if you have any shame for anybody up here, you can just tuck that in and keep
it
to yourself.
Bad.
But we're
good. Yeah. But I do feel like that's like one of the most powerful things about doing like stand up is like, yes, not everyone has my same life story, but when I tell jokes, I can connect with people. There's humanity there. You know what I mean? Like, yeah. You're seeing like, oh shit, you know, she goes through the same shit. Like, there's day-to-day stuff that people relate to, mm-hmm. and that's dope. Like, I don't want to be an inspiration, but I want to be like visible. And it's like, yeah, that's important. We're all going through shit. Like, just because I can't see your shit, just because you have two legs and two arms, and I don't see anything wrong with the way you walk, does not mean you have not been through some shit.
Right.
Truly.
Or that you don't have a disability or something.
Exactly. So it's like, you know, we could all just have maybe a little more empathy with each other. Like, that would be dope. Aww. Maybe. I don't know. Like,
I love
that. Don't pity me. Just be, like, chiller and nicer to, like, the other people in your life and strangers.
And we'll see a ripple effect from that.
That's right.
Yeah.
I truly believe that.
But also, I am a huge cunt on my stand-up, so at the same time.
I was watching your stand-up and, like, completing the sentences before I knew what you were going to say, so I guess I'm a little see you next Tuesday. My friends talk to me. They don't like me using the word
cunt
in front of their babies.
I mean,
in front of their babies.
The baby can't talk. Not yet.
They're listening. They are listening.
Yeah. We're going to get into an Into the Woods right
we
now
are.
Reference.
Let's do a time check.
Children
we
will
could
listen.
We at this should. Point, yep. Transition to tea time.
Yay.
Now the fun, yes.
Well, I love when we say something like, this is a thing. We're expecting you to get excited, but you don't know.
Well, the fun thing about tea time, they don't know. The fun thing about tea time is we don't actually drink tea. No tea has ever been drunk at tea time.
Wow. We did have tea-flavored vodka one time.
Okay. That counts. Tea. There we go. I stand corrected. So today we have mimosas.
Yay. Because we hear you're a brunch enthusiast.
I fucking love brunch.
Yes. Brunch is our brand.
I brunch for the culture out here asking for poached eggs on a Sunday. I'm sorry. It's not brunch if you don't have a poached egg.
You're right.
How dare you?
You're right. I can't eat eggs. They don't like me.
Really?
Yeah, I'm kind of allergic / they just
what
don't.
Do you get at brunch then?
All the sides, bacon, potatoes. Hash browns, more potatoes.
But you have a mimosa.
And I normally don't even get orange juice in my mimosas.
Oh, no, just champagne.
Just champagne.
Mimosa is like, it's like.
I think it has a different name.
It's like baby brunch.
Champagne. That's baby brunch.
Baby brunch. At a certain point, you upgrade and you're like, we don't need to fuck with that. We don't need to. Why are we messing up a good thing?
That's what your 20s are for. Mm-hmm. I'm trying to be classy. I would like a mimosa.
Like,
and your 30s are like, give me the whole bottle.
Can I do the bottle? Wait, what did you say? You were like, is it possible if I could? That's the brunch. Is it possible if we could just things? Oh, no, no. Oh, they're bottomless things.
That's how my server knows to spit in my mimosas when I go, is it possible?
Great.
So for tea time, in addition to drinking, which we have talked about a lot, mm-hmm. we'll play a game. In our live shows, we like to tell stories. But the inspiration for our stories is always something someone has said in the audience. So Maya
mm-hmm.
is up.
Hello.
And walking.
Can I get
and
mic?
Going to, if anybody has a suggestion for something that will like spark a story from one mm-hmm. of us,
yeah,
she'll
like
pass
two
you
words,
the mic.
Two and keywords.
You wait for the mic because we're going to release this later and we need the sound.
Two keywords. They don't need to be related. We will find in ourselves a story to tell, one of us.
Test. Someone raise a hand.
Tailgating, people-gating.
What is people
and
gating?
Penis?
I'm so confused.
And penis.
What is people gating?
That's all right. We'll figure it out. We're
penis,
professionals.
Penis, people-gating, tailgating.
Tailgating and penis. Tailgating and penis. When have I ever
make
tailgated
it work.
With
make
penis?
It work, ladies.
Make it work.
See, this isn't a question of if I have stories. It's what stories.
Well, you went to Howard. They have a football team. Is that, that's a question? That's a question. I don't know. Is it the one with the ball that's black and white, or is it the the green one with the lines? I don't.
You guys. My mom is here. Okay, so since you brought it up, yes, I lived in a sports dorm my sophomore year of college at Howard University.
Did you do sports? I don't mean to interrupt.
I did not do sports.
Mm-hmm. Interesting.
Well, I guess it was the sports and honors, and just they just roped everyone with potential into one big old dormitory. And unsurprisingly, I dated my next door neighbor. He was my boyfriend. You know, it was cute for as long as it lasted. And I also dated a downstairs neighbor whose virginity I did take. I will say, oh God, my mom's like right there, so I'm just not gonna look over that way. But yes, I did take a young man's virginity at Howard University.
I love the way you framed that. That's super feminist.
Okay.
I did. I was very tender. I was gentle and understanding.
Yes. Did you light a candle for him?
In my heart. And he's happily married now. He's a dentist. He has like a wife and a child. She kind of looks like me, but it's fine. But it's fine. I love going on Instagram and looking at what my life could be. Like, sideswipe that one. Whoa, Matrix. Yeah. But yeah, I guess, I mean, a great story from that specific instance, since we brought up sports dorms and penises and tailgating, I guess I learned from that experience that it is not okay, or let me know, I learned that it's not okay when a guy takes you out on, I guess, you guys' first date and it's Valentine's Day, don't order the lobster?
Girl, you always order the lobster.
Hello! He talked to his tennis coach and said, like, yeah, like, she ordered the lobster, and the tennis coach was like, she what? This girl must, oh my goodness. And I was like, yeah, I ordered the lobster and a baked potato, and I was still hungry.
I never played tennis. Is this the kind of thing that people talk about with their coaches?
Apparently, ask Serena. I guess this is what they be talking about off the field.
You called it the field. Bitch, even I know.
She said the field.
I told you guys I don't play sports. I told you guys, don't act surprised. It's all supposed to look like green fields anyway. So, I think that's enough story time for me.
Okay.
Courtney, out.
That was great.
Thanks.
That was great. Okay, we need two more.
Two more. You get the
idea. Hi, Carla. Hi, Kenny.
Hey, Carla. While we...
Ooh, we got some words over there.
We got a lot of volunteers in this area. What's your name? Shout out for the show. Yeah. Mina. What's your word?
Samosa.
Ooh, samosa.
Love it.
Yeah, delicious food. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. One more word.
Pineapple samosa.
Did it have to start with a P?
No.
Any word. Any letter.
I think that person just wanted to say penis.
Yeah.
Don't blame this on us, girl.
Did.
Tell your truth. Okay. Speak your truth.
Yeah.
Samosa, pineapple.
Danielle, I'm
delicious
so happy this
food.
One's going to you.
Wow. As a person whose parents are from the Dominican Republic, I feel very typecast right now. feel very put upon. pineapple. A samosa pineapple. Man, this story don't have to do with either of those things.
just tell us a story, girl. This is brunch.
Brunch. Okay. Recently, I did go abroad. Thank you.
Yes. Where'd you go?
She's worth it.
Thank you. I was in Puerto Vallarta for my friend's bachelorette party.
Fun.
Yeah.
Lit,
but like, look, I love a bachelorette party. I do like to party, but at a certain point, it's like, I want to go home. I don't want to go to the club. I'm tired of the club. Look, you're retiring from the club. That's why we're here. You know, that's why we're at Club Med. So
let's practice.
Can we just chill by the pool? No, I love it. It was great. I love supporting my friends and being there for them. But my favorite parts about being in Puerto Vallarta were we like went on a day boat situation. Mm-hmm. I was like, ooh, boats, buoyancy, boobs out, living. What happened was, like, we went snorkeling, and I jumped off the boat, did not thinking about, like, how I was going to get back onto the boat. I was like, oh, fuck. There were stairs back onto the boat. That's what there were. I was like, no stairs off, stairs on. And I was like, oh, I guess I live here now.
You're a mermaid.
I looked at the fish. I was like, I guess I'm part of your world.
Yeah.
Yes, clap for that.
That was good. That was good.
Finally, the solution was to have me swim to another boat that still had stairs, but this time, people I didn't know from the ocean were, like, lifting my ass up out of it.
Sorry, can you say that phrase again? People you didn't know
people
from
I
the
did
ocean.
Not know from the ocean.
So they were people from the ocean that you didn't know?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
It became, our boat captain was hollering at other boat captains. It was a very popular drop-off spot for people.
Yeah.
It was an ocean community really came together for me.
Wow.
You know, let a real assist. I went over, hit the deck just like a fatty tuna. It was like catch of the day. Clearly, I fetch a lot
of
market.
Put it on your Tinder profile.
I can see that. I see it.
Catch of the day. It was cool. You know, Puerto Vallarta was nice. I had a pineapple there.
Hey.
Had a pineapple, had some fresh fruit. The best part, though, was, like, pharmacia. Anyone in here know what pharmacia means?
Pharmacia?
It's Mexican for legal drugs without a prescription.
Yes!
Pharmacia was legit. Okay, I had a game plan. I was like, I need these people to be on my team. I need them to be on my side. I need them to help me. Okay.
Amen.
So I started off with something real legit. I was like, 4 albuterol inhalers. All right. Letting you know
it
that
does give you a little
I come
rush
in peace.
In the heart.
It does. It mm-hmm. helps. It speeds things up a little bit. Not as much as we'd like, though. I think she gave it to me. Fine. No problem. Cool. Then I asked for Adderall. They did not have Adderall.
What?
But they did have Ritalin. I was like, oh, I see you trying to work with me. You know? There's a relationship that's being built, you know? We have a nice back and forth. There's rapport happening. I got really bold. I asked, at that point, then she offered me painkillers. And I was like, ooh, Vicodin.
Yes.
Ding, 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 we have a winner.
Yes.
I felt very cool. I was like, what? I don't have to suck your dick or pretend to like your band? Like, this is so dope. It was really, really great. Pharmacia is amazing. I love it very much.
The whole room just clenched.
They
so
were like,
hard.
Oh.
Relax.
Oh, I'm sorry. I will not take one for the team. I'm not Andy. I'm not that bitch. Sorry. And then I lost my shit on a customs agent.
Oh my gosh.
Knowing full well I had a bag of pharmacia in my possession.
Indignant.
I was so furious. I started using words like ableist, just words his GED would not understand. And he was like, your attitude is a red flag. My job is to look for red flags. And I was like, I think your adult braces are more of a red flag. He didn't like that.
I'm sorry.
He didn't like that.
Are you a ghost right now? You
no.
survived this?
Like I
you're
survived.
Actually here right
look,
now?
Bitch.
Girl.
Don't test me.
Okay.
I don't got no feet, but I can stand my ground. All right? That's what's up. That's what's up.
Ayo.
He was like, you want to dance? Bitch, I dance. I twerk off my wheelchair. Do not try me.
Yes.
He sent me through that x-ray scanner machine. I got my pharmacia, and I live to tell the tale.
Hello.
And then she had a samosa.
Samosas and pineapple.
Samosas.
Yay.
Yay,
we
that's
did
a story. That was a great story. It had twists and turns I didn't expect.
Drugs.
And a happy ending.
I got my friend from Canada to bring me more albuterol inhalers. I love just smuggling drugs. I love that's my favorite thing.
Do you have
girl.
Asthma?
I do.
Oh, okay.
Do you?
I was like, I don't care if it's UTI infection, just give it to me. As long as it's contraband, I'm here for it.
Girl, we got something in common. Cool.
So, Dara.
Yes.
We had a Twitter suggestion for Teen Time Words.
Interactivity.
From the Twitters.
We'll see if you want to maybe accept them or
let's decide.
Toss it back to the audience.
Yeah.
Let's hear it.
Cat and vomit. Oh.
And it wasn't cat vomit.
It wasn't cat vomit.
It was just cat.
And vomit.
And vomit. I don't know. I don't do a lot of vomiting. Pretty well, good at drinking. Hi, Dad.
Your poor dad.
I know. He's like, I don't even know.
Have you had
anymore.
Any experiences where somebody that had like had a cat vomited?
Of course, I've never met anyone with a cat.
What?
That's
you
true.
Audience, you guys got something better than a cat and vomit? Yeah, I trust this one right here.
Yeah.
She's black. I trust her.
Yeah, we're excited.
Fine. What do you got for us? Oh, you
Saturday
had that
night
story.
Hair removal.
Saturday night and
See
hair
how my
removal.
Eyes
That's her wheel.
Choice.
Oh, I'm
Honey.
Excited about this one.
Have you been spying on me? My God.
These are things I do on my Saturday nights because I don't date. It's not like a rule, but nobody wants to date me. So
it's not true.
We can change that tonight.
Maybe.
You guys, wow.
Or Lara
Ellison.
We're going to keep
slide
on.
Slide into the DM. No, don't.
Don't.
Seriously, don't. So, when I first moved to San Francisco, I had, no judgment, a perm. I have, in my whole life, had a perm for about 6 months of the life.
That's not a lot.
It's very short.
Yeah.
I just need to make sure it's said because the person who is the reason I couldn't have a perm is sitting right there.
Holler. Shout out
Holler.
To Dad.
Perms
are poison.
Black power. Because I wanted to do like a short cut thing because, you know, Rihanna was doing the thing and I was living with this girl, Christina Elmore. If you don't know who she is, you should look her up. She's super cute. She used to have a short thing and I was like, I'm going to do that too. And I would go to the salon and get it done. And the girl loved me because I would always get, like, random colors in my hair. Things have changed. I've grown up now. And, and then I was poor. So, so I stopped
that.
Going to the salon.
Yes.
And I was like, we can do this ourselves. I'm just going to go ahead to the little store and pick up the perm and then do it myself. And what I did was I picked up a perm that also had color in it because I like efficiency. And I forgot that, like, every warning ever tells you not to do that. You're not supposed to color and perm. And when I say perm, for like black people, perms are straight. Because I don't need any more curl. I'm good.
Yeah.
Straight.
Oh my God.
Yeah, but it was a cute burgundy. And like, how could I say no?
In general, you're not supposed to do two processes on your hair in one day. And you said, let me do the two in one.
I'm also in the future. I know this was a bad idea. But I did it in my little bathroom with my two roommates there. We're all like in our little rooms, and I'm like, oh, it's gonna look so cute. And I start washing it out.
My mom's laughing.
And the fuzz is coming out, and the foam is coming out, and the hair is coming out, girl.
Oh, no.
Again, I'm in the future. Thank you, Mike Birbiglia. I'm stealing that from him.
Yes.
So it, like, not all of my hair broke off. I still figured out a way to make it work. And I was like, this was like 10 years ago, so I was really cute. And so I was just like, don't pay attention to this. Look at the face. And then, and I started to wear very big bows in my head. I had a time period where
I remember
every
this.
Just like an ugly baby trying to distract.
Oh, that's exactly
don't
what
look
it
at
is.
You, look at
the She called me an ugly baby, and I'm.
I didn't want to bring
on.
That up, but.
Yeah, so I would go to Forever 21 because we were living in Knob Hill. I would walk down to Forever 21, hey. Which is not there anymore actually, and buy like a little headband. Bow that was very like a big flower, like a giant thing. Like I was going to a
you
British
work
funeral.
Them bows though, girl. You work them bows. Okay. Yes. You worked on bows. And so that's when we became friends.
Because of the bows, obviously. That's what it sounded like. And I was working in North Beach at the time. And so going from Nob Hill to North Beach, this is actually why I started this group called YBSF, which is Young Black SF in the Bay, because I would walk from work to home, and then from home to work, and I never saw a single black person. Yeah.
Unless they were homeless.
True. Yeah. Sorry.
That's true.
Yeah, we saw a black person walking outside of our apartment one day, and I called my roommates to the window, and we all were like...
No.
Where do you think he's going?
Oh, and isn't it so tempting to follow them? And you're like, let me
literally,
not.
That was the conversation that we had. We were like, should we say something? San Francisco.
You see something, say something.
Right. And so I occasionally would take the cable car because when you work here and there's a hill in the middle, like you can't help but go over the hill. And then one day I forgot my bow, and the cable car operator was like, "Oh, girl, where's your bow?" And y'all don't know this about me, but because I know it's like not intuitive because I am here on stage. I don't like to be known.
She's like, so known.
Bitch, the whole reason we're here is because you're known.
No, but literally. In this forum, when it's like I have a microphone and you chuckle, like that's what I like. When people are like, where's your dog today? I'm like, no, you don't know me. Mm. I go to another store now. And so that's when I was like. First of all, I can't take the cable car anymore, and that's okay, because my legs look real good after I decided to walk to work every day.
Oh, wow. Yes.
I didn't expect that, but I'll
Yes, legs.
And eventually I grew my hair out, because San Francisco is too foggy to have a perm anyway.
It's true.
And here we are. And the day that I lost a lot of my hair was a Saturday, so I did it.
Wow.
There it is.
I didn't expect that. I thought you were just going to talk about, like, taking maybe extensions out or something, but it really got removed.
Yeah.
In a permanent...
I thought I would go with the one that was, like, against my will, but also my fault.
Ah, mm-hmm. Great story. Yeah. Great story.
Oh, thank you. Mm-hmm. Oh, thank you so much.
All right, well, that was tea time.
I think we've done it.
We did the things.
We did
the tea. That was some good tea, wasn't it?
Good tea.
You guys found out some things about us.
Before we wrap this up, Danielle, where can people find you in real life if you want them to stalk you like I suggested, online, if not?
I love being known. Please know me. Please buy me drinks. No. TheDaniellePerez.com. I have all of my dates. I'm in Los Angeles, but I'll come up to SF. Book me. Tell Punchline
Book
Cops
her.
You want me on their shows.
Yes.
Also, you can follow me on Twitter and Instagram at Diva Deluxe. No E at the end.
Hello.
That's right. How about you?
And you guys, oh my God. You all can follow me at It's Olivia Dope on Instagram and Twitter.
And can we follow you in real life, Courtney?
You can't follow me in the streets of San Francisco anymore in real life because I'm moving, I'm going to New York for 3 months on tomorrow morning.
That's so exciting.
I fly out. I'm going to do a play off Broadway called Shirley Goodness and Mercy. It's so exciting.
We're excited.
I haven't been on stage acting. This has been something. But I haven't been acting. It's been more than wonderful.
RE Theater.
Wonderful and a pleasure and an honor.
RE Theater.
RE Theater. That's where I got my degree. I haven't done it in like 4 or 5 years. So this is a little bit of I got to take a leap back. And
I think
I can do it. I did good in the audition. They gave me the part. So I think I can do this.
You're about to get on a plane. You're doing it.
I'm about to get on a plane and I am not packed. So
if anyone wants to follow her home
and help me pack, some of you already have offers out on the table. Yeah, mama. And that's it.
That's it.
Yeah, keep updated.
I am at Dara M. Wilson. It's you can remember it because it's my name. Please include the M. There is a Dara Wilson roaming around the world who went to jail for beating the hell out of her kids. And it's not me.
It's not our Dara.
I have been running away from that lady since I started applying for college, actually.
Right.
Actually, the only reason I perform is to boost my SEO.
Right.
That's what I'm doing right now.
Get that SEO.
So keep searching me.
Amen. And you can follow Dara and I both at NBT The Show on Instagram or Twitter. And please subscribe on YouTube as well. We have two more episodes left to release.
Yes. We did WakandaCon last year, and we're about to put that episode out. It's super dope.
One of the founders, we interviewed her, and then another fantastic guest at the end of that.
Yeah, that's true. And we do want to say, because we're all about like supporting the culture, you are here, you are in Piano Fight. There is another show here tonight
at
8 p.m. by a sketch group called Nice Tan.
Give them some love.
They're so funny.
Shout out to Nice Tan.
They're so funny.
We literally found, we became friends with the founder of that group, Nice Tan, because when we got into SF Sketchfest last year, I said, who are all the other black people doing shows in Sketchfest? And she was one of the first ones listed, and we've been friends ever since.
Yeah. We did an episode of Next Big Thing with her, so you can find that as well. Her name is Carla Lee. We keep saying her.
Carla Lee. And the show is called Up All Night, and it's happening in that main stage theater behind us here at 8 p.m. So we encourage you to stay. We'll be hanging around so we can chat and drink, say goodbye, or see you later to me for now. Yeah. I know.
Buy her a drink. Send her off, you know.
No, because I still need to pack, but you can give me
a couple
drinks.
That's the best way to pack.
I know. I know.
Show to New York just like, surprise.
I don't know.
What y'all got?
Just grabbing everything that brings you joy.
That's exactly what I'm doing.
That's literally how I'm planning right now. This doesn't bring me joy. Go away.
Thank you all so much for coming out tonight. We're so excited to be able to do this again.
Such a beautiful crowd. Such a beautiful, diverse.
I love it.
You guys are going to kill it this week. I don't know what you're all doing, but you're going to kill it. Just so you know.
Yeah, congratulations on your next week, because you're going to kill it, because you got all these vibes from us.
Yeah.
I like that dance.
Yeah, okay.
All right. Thank you all for coming.
Yeah, we're releasing you now.
And you are released, and good night.